Talk with Lenora. Morning Talk. Morning Talk with Lenora.
Good morning. Welcome to the Morning Talk with Lenora. Good Friday morning, and I hope it's a great start for you all. It's a very slow start for me. You know, you have a lot of, you know, I wanted to start this early, but I had like little things that kept going wrong. So, you know, you just keep plugging at stuff and eventually, you know, they'll get right. Well, you know, I had an interesting week and, you know, kind of made some decisions on what I want to do. And, one of those things is I decided that I want to be more than just a virtual girl living in a virtual world. So I decided that I would try online dating. So I thought I'd try it. Well, before trying it, you know, I set up a profile on one of the sites. I'll get back to that later. Anyway, I decided I would do some, like, research, because after setting up my profile, I didn't understand how people communicate on it. You know, I'm already, like, uncomfortable, because, you know, it's, you know, even with basic texting, you know, you only interpret the words from other people on your interpretation. But you really don't know in the tone and the manner that they are sending it. So I already had a problem with that. I guess it's just me, you know. I guess everybody is afraid of me. So anyway, I decided that maybe I need to learn a little bit more about it. Just jumped in there and got all confused. So I did a little, you know, like most people, we Google. And I landed upon the site that had the best dating apps of 2018. Well, as the most popular, they chose Zoosk, which I knew nothing about. You know, I'll tell you what I knew about. So Zoosk, they set up tons of matches, and they do it based on preferences. And one thing I learned about online site too is you got to know what you want to do and why you want to do it. So Zeus is one of those sites that is good for those people who want to be set up. So they take all this information about you, and then they set you up. They also got a cool thing called office photo verification. So I guess it's a little safety measure. I tried to sign on, you know, to check it out, but I was just overwhelmed by just the sign-up page. I was like, not ready to divulge all that right there. I just wasn't ready yet. So I didn't sign up for Zeus yet. So I don't have anything bad to say about it or anything. I just haven't signed up yet. Then number two was Match.com. Now everybody heard of Match.com. They got commercials and everything. They make successful matches for over 20 years. And I know they have been around a while. And I signed up for them once. Now they have a very thorough questionnaire to kind of get you to the right place, to the right person. And from my understanding, they're very successful at matching people. Maybe when I am in that place, and I did sign up, I did try to do a profile. I haven't put a picture on anything yet. But, you know, it was like going by, I had to fix up. Well, for some reason, it got me as a guy looking for a girl. So all the matches are women. So now I got to take that down. Because I'm like, where did I miss that question? So I'm going to try it, but I got to go back and redo it. I guess this is one of the things happens when you sign up. Another one is they got for dating over 50 is called Our Time. I've heard the advertisement. I didn't sign up for that one yet. It's a dating app site for 50 years old and older, singles looking for love, companionship, and other stuff. I guess I haven't signed up for it yet. I mean, I qualify, but I just, you know, I gotta take baby steps, because it's overwhelming to me. It is. I know that someone brought it to my attention that I just can't stay on mid videos. I need to get out and socialize. So I agree with them. And I'm like, you know what? I'm okay with that, because I agree. I can't be a virtual girl living in a virtual world. But, you know, I had some things that kind of prohibited that. So I'm looking to socialize. So I thought I'd try dating apps. Well, number four is Elite Singles. I've never heard of this one at all. And it's for serious online dating for professional singles. I don't know if that is somebody who's a single, who's been single for long and that makes them professional, or single that works, that makes them professional. But it's for best for dating seeking serious relationship potential for long-term commitment. And that's Elite Singles. So, I guess I'll look into that later to learn more about it. And the fifth one was Black People Meet. Online dating for Black people looking to connect. I've looked into it. Like I say, they're all just very overwhelming to me. I mean, it's hard enough to meet people in person. And I mean, I don't know about everybody else, but I know I'm behind the times and I probably need to get with it. But I, you know, DM talking and messenger talking and text talking. I mean, I don't have a problem with that, but you know, what I found about the online is that you're only judged by how you looked. I would prefer somebody would get to know me and knew, you know, what kind of person I am. You know, what, you know, I would like to get to know them and find out what we have in common and have really good conversations. Like, I like to take pictures. We can probably go on a photo shoot, or I want to have fun. You know, but when you go on a dating app, people pick you on how you look, and then what I don't understand is, I really appreciate it. I don't have a problem with that. But when people say, your picture is nice, that's nice. But they don't say nothing else. So how do you have a conversation with somebody that just keep telling you got a nice picture? So I don't understand that. Or they put canned responses like, your profile stood out. Or, you know, it's things that the app provides for you. So I feel like they're bots. So I'm like, is this a robot? Because they keep saying the same thing, that I like a picture or a flirt. And I mean, I don't know. So I mean, I'm positive and I'm open. So I'm not negative about it, but I don't understand it. And the information that I'm giving you, I received it from a free online resource. And just to let you know, these particular five were chosen because this online site, they get money for advertising these sites. But they did give me information. And it was a good starting point for my personal search. So that's where my information come from. And I'm going to try it. But I realize I don't know much about it. So I'm searching for myself. And that's how I stumbled on the site. They also had some very good other points that I appreciated, because now I feel more informed. Like, before deciding on which app you want to use, you need to decide what you're looking for. Makes sense, right? Like, whether you're interested in meeting interesting people, or you want to start again after having a heartbreak, or you're searching for that person to start a family with, or the one. I've seen people say, I'm looking for the one. To me, when I'm on the site, I liken it to looking for clothes. You know how you shop for clothes online? You just look at the clothes and you read about it, you see the price. Well, that's how I kind of see it. Because some people are nowhere near me, they're out of state, and I'm like, this is not going to happen. So, I mean, like I say, this is just me. I don't know. Another thing, the apps are, you know, they're good for whatever reason you decide to go on. So each app, like Elite Singles, you know, they have a lengthy questionnaire process, but they're for people who are looking for serious relationships. Maybe everybody's not. Maybe some people want a pen pal. They just want companionship. They don't want to, like, get married and have children. So if you're serious and you're 50, they say Our Time is a good site for that. Do you prefer being matched or searched? Never even thought considered that. I never even thought that was an issue. Like, you know, some singles want to search through profiles, decide who to chat with. That might be me. But I guess that's me. That's why I call it looking for clothes. Because I like looking through it. But then I do talk, and then I'm like, I like your profile. I like your picture. You didn't even write that. But I'm trying. And then other people feel more comfortable being set up. I think that's probably what I probably need to do, because obviously I'm not doing it right. So maybe I'll get a app the time to the chance to do it for me. That's something I might look into. I think that's probably the best way for me, because I'm not doing it right. I already know that. One of the major benefits of using the dating site is that they match you up with people according to your values and your characteristics and the things that matter to you most. So that's what all those long questionnaires about. You kind of give a description. Like, I signed up for one, and that's the one that I missed, the one about saying that I was a woman. I was asking questions and faces were popping in the bottom. I was like, they're all girls. So I got to undo that one. Another benefit of dating online is that it brings together enormous amounts of people and who you would probably otherwise never meet. And that's true, because then you get to see people who are in your local area. I'm like, you know, I live here too, and there ain't no way I'm seeing them, because look what I'm doing. I'm talking to a camera. So it's a benefit. Which features matter most? So that's when you decide, like I said, Zeus boasts the photo verification feature to ensure that users are honest, and Match.com does the same thing. Because, you know, I remember someone commented, and I think I had an onk, and they commented about the onk, that they like onk. They said, if that's you. So I'm like, I guess I just sort of smiled. But I was like, why would I put another woman's picture up on my thing? But I guess people do. I'm serious. You know, so I didn't, you know, but I thought that was kind of funny. Or that, you know, people put pictures that you can't even see them. Or people put no pictures at all. And that one, I don't even address people and put pictures at all. Why are you on here? You know, so you got to explore the different features of the different sites. Like I say, if you're looking to search yourself, or you're looking for them to hook you up. And then it also matters on how much they cost. Many of their top dating apps offer free sign up or free trial period. But if you want to unlock any features, or like, you know, if you want somebody that you want to answer somebody back who like you, or who like your picture, or they want to get to know you better, then you got to pay. And some of them are reasonable. I mean, You don't have to, you know, there's like short periods where you don't have to subscribe long. So, as I said, I do have a profile out there. And I have two, and I got, you know, I got a couple. I don't have a picture yet. I went to one, and this guy said, "Do you know what kind of site this is?" And I go, "No, I'm not on that site anymore." Because if you're going to ask, I'm like, "No." So I'm not on that anymore. So if you ever thought about dating online, give it a try. I mean, I'm quite nervous about it, but what's a girl to do? You know, what is there to do? Good luck to you all who decide to give it a try. If I can, anybody can. So maybe I have a success story. I'll be in one of those commercials. I met the true love of my life on this dating app. You know, anything's possible. So maybe that'll happen to me. Or maybe it happened to you. So until that happens right now, I'll call it a day. So thank you for watching The Morning Talk with Lenora. And have a great day on me.
So y'all have a great day, and I'll talk to you soon. Thank you for joining me. Please subscribe to my channel and like. And if you have any questions, put them in the comments. I'll try to answer them. Bye.